writers had a great idea, which was basically to throw 13 people out of an airplane and have Jarvis tell Tony he can only carry 4. So how in the world, as they're plummeting to their death, is Iron Man going to be able to save them? And Tony begins to fly down and grab onto people and tells those people to grab onto the next person. And suddenly, with this great show of teamwork, you have 13 people all latched onto each other with Iron Man blowing his repulsors to stop their fall.
With something as complicated as you can imagine of people falling out of Air Force One and Iron Man ultimately saving them, how do you achieve it? And your first approach is, let's do it on a green screen stage. We can hang the actors. We have a lot of control. But our second unit director came on board and said, I know the Red Bull skydiving team. Let's do a test.
I don't believe a lot of people thought it could be done practically. And I'm like, I know we can do this for real. I actually got a bunch of the skydivers that we're using, and we went out to the airport and spent 2 days jumping and doing some of the harder various bits of the sequence.
It was so successful that we said, let's shoot it this way. And I was still skeptical, thinking, are we gonna get all these shots?
And we start building custom costumes with hidden parachutes. Jake Brake is the one who did that. He's been doing that since the very first Moonraker, when James Bond jumped out of the airplane with no parachute. He spent about 2 months building all these hidden parachutes and testing them. 8 days to shoot it, we ended up making 62 airplane loads, over 600 parachute jumps, 480-some hidden parachute jumps, which is by far bigger than any kind of a sequence like that's ever been done before.
Watching dailies, it was truly terrifying. And seeing the cameraman point, you know, from 10,000 feet in the air and you see the ground approach, it's phenomenal. Having Iron Man in that scene and 13 people falling adds such excitement because it's visceral. You feel that they are really in midair. You can't really achieve that anywhere else.
I'm pretty proud of pulling it off. Not to mention that at the end, we continually swung them back and forth over Cape Fear River.
That was the very last part of the sequence where I think they were about 80 or 90 feet up in the air. We started them zipping down, and as they come down over the water, then one after the other, we start releasing them from their zip lines. That was mostly the brainchild of Jim Churchman.
We didn't want to do the CGs. We want real people, real water, real sky. We want, you know, real speed. It just makes it that much more epic.
This is a 165-ton crane stretched out about 160 feet in the air. We have another 90-ton crane that's stretched out to about 75 feet. And we basically have a 15-zipline rig set up that's motivated by a vehicle. We run them up to 30 miles an hour, get the shots we need, and ultimately drop them in the water.
It was a big deal. Came off amazingly flawless.
Ready and action!
The challenge of these films from the visual effects point of view is just the sheer massivity of the amount of shots and how we go globally to make sure that we get all of this done within the time that we have. The technology is always being perfected and getting better.
One of the key things with all visual effects is you want to make it spectacular and interesting, but you also want to try and make it as real as possible.
I think what's really cool is that Iron Man has this heroic moment, but technically is super challenging. There's a certain way that you skydive to protect yourself and not just dump.